Hi, good morning everyone. Today we will be talking about some basics, right? Before proceeding further in the digital marketing, we have discussed about what is digital marketing, how digital marketing is winning over traditional and conventional marketing, what are the major differences between all those in these two, and in between, we have also talked about different methods of digital marketing. I have introduced you with SEO, SEM, social media, right, mobile advertising, display advertising, and all. We will talk detail all these things about all those things in the next slides. And later, we covered about Google Analytics. I introduced you about how we can find out, we can analyze the campaigns on the last. On the last lecture we talked about digital marketing process, how we have to know about our client's business, his goals, objectives, and then we have to find out the customer segments, customer prospective, customer profiles, right? And we have to define buyer personas, the buyer basically. And today we move to again the very basic things like internet, that is in the course. What is internet? We all know about internet, and even many common people you may have seen in your life, they are confused about internet and World Wide Web, and many thinks that Google is internet. When you talk to them, they start internet, then they just go to Google and will start that that's internet. And internet is basically global system, networks of networks. Many local networks are there in the organizations. Like in Graphic Era, we have our local network, and that is connected with the internet. Again, multiple companies has their own local network, where multiple systems, maybe 10, maybe 50, maybe 100, maybe 1000 are connected in a local network. And we call it intranet basically, intranet, right? And intranet is local network within an organization, maybe a single building or multiple buildings in the vicinity. And the second thing is we have extranet as well. Extranet is we connect our suppliers and our customers with our network, and with the network with the organization and the organization's suppliers of raw material and other supplies, and also customers if they have connected, or we can say dealers, distributors, channel partners. If organization is connecting, then that is extranet. Intranet is network of networks worldwide. Intranet is network within an organization, within a single building or multiples in the vicinity. Extranet is intranet plus connected suppliers and distributors. Suppliers are those who are supplying you, maybe raw material, maybe components, maybe parts. And dealers and distributors are to whom you are supplying, right? And if they are connected with you, then that is extranet. The internet is the global system of interconnected computer networks that uses the internet protocol, TCP/IP, Transmission Control Protocol, Internet Protocol. That is basically, protocol is what? It is a software as such. And as we have operating system on our laptop or on our smartphone, maybe Android or iOS, right, on a smartphone, that is what? That is operating system. Similarly, protocol would carry, and it is in between to which we cannot touch, in between the connects, right, your computers, servers, routers, switches, cables, everything. That is TCP/IP. To communicate between networks and devices, we use TCP/IP to communicate between networks and devices, as we use operating system. It is a network of networks that consist of private, public, academic, business and government networks of local to global scope, linked by a broad array of electronic, wireless and optical networking technologies. Right, different switches, cables, hubs, right, that connect all network worldwide. The internet carries a vast range of information resources and services, such as the interlinked hypertext documents, that is web, HTTP, hypertext transmission protocol, right? Application of the World Wide Web, electronic mail, telephony and file sharing. These HTTP is another on the websites, www. Electronic mail, we have mail servers, mailing system, telephony and file sharing. Web telephony, as we know. The internet is basically network of networks where TCP/IP communicates between different switches, hubs and these networks. Private and government networks, right? That is about internet. Network and networks. Internet and web, right? A global networks of networks and computers, servers, smartphones, that is all on the internet. A collection of information accessed through the internet. Web is collection of information, multiple websites, millions of websites hosted on different web servers. Collection of information accessed through internet, but we access that information using internet, that is on the internet. As we have a computer, we have a laptop, that is hardware. On the internet, we have multiple networks that made of hardware, servers, computers, and cables, fibers, switches, hubs. And above that is an operating like transmission control protocol TCP/IP. Over that we have websites, software like internet software. Getting a collection of information accessed through internet. That websites, these websites we accessed using internet. Right? And here the network infrastructure. Information travels via networks protocols, TCP/IP, can access through a variety of ways. A variety of ways we can access that internet. Information travels primarily through HTTP, Hypertext Transmission Protocol. Uses browsers to access documents and web pages. We use Mozilla Firefox, Google Chrome, Internet Explorer, Microsoft Internet Explorer. These are the browsers to access information, to access your www.gehu.ac.in. We are using browser to access. Navigation of other pages occurs through hyperlinks. Whom, about us, contacts, other, these are the links on which we click and then we reaches to next page. We call it hyperlinks. Everyone knows. We call it hyperlink. So these are the basic things about internet and web. The difference, internet basically is hardware plus protocol, TCP/IP, and websites are collection of informations hosted on different servers and travels primarily through HTTP, right? Websites, a website, also written as website, different, right, is a collection of web pages, different pages and related content that is identified by a common domain name like gehu.ac.in. It is a domain name and published on at least one web server. If we say about the website, that is, two things are necessary. One is name of the website, domain name, to which we call domain name, right? Just GEHU is domain name, dot AC dot in is extension. We call it domain extension. .com is domain extension. .net is domain extension. .in is domain extension. .org is domain extension. .edu is domain extension. And these are for different purposes. Signifies different purposes. If you call .gov, it means government website. If extension is .gov. If it is .gov.in, that is Indian government websites. If .in, that is India. Later we are introducing new extensions from many years. So now we have country-wise extension as well. Like .in is used for India, .us is for US, .uk is for United Kingdom, right? So this is country-wise. Organization-wise, if .net, that is network-related organizations, internet service providers or others such, they use .net. .com is for commercial organizations. .ac is for academic organizations. .edu again for educational organizations, right? Criteria, that is. And we have now .info, .tv, multiple domain extensions we are using for different industry segments, for different industries. These represents different types of industries as well now. Domain name is the name of the company, and .com, .edu, whatever it is, that is domain extension, right? So for a website, when we talk about a website, we first need a domain name with extension, and we need a hosting space on web servers. We need a hosting space on web server. Web server is a large computer having high processing capacity and as well as high storage capacity, 24 hours connected with 24/7, 365 connected with high speed internet, connected with high speed internet connection, so that anytime, for anywhere, anyone can access the information. Hosting, that is a web server, is the server having high processing as well as storage capacity. Number two things are there: high processing, high storage capacity. And the most important thing is it is always 24/7, 365 connected with high internet speed, so that information can be accessed from anywhere in the world, anytime. Then we call it web server. So we book, we hire, we rent a space on web servers. So we have a space, 1 GB space we have taken on a web server. And for hosting, we call it a hosting space. So whenever you talk about, we plan about making a website, you need two things at least. First thing is domain name. Second is hosting space. Right? After that, you can have database on the server. You can go for the database. You can go for the security, that S you find on HTTPS, security service. Lot of other services are there. The basic I'm talking about, one the name and where the website will live, right? So notable examples are Wikipedia.org, Google.com and Amazon.com. All publicly accessible websites collectively constitute the World Wide Web. As I said, all publicly accessible websites collectively constitute the World Wide Web. There are also private websites that can only be accessed on a private network, such as companies' internal websites for its employees. I said intranet. Users can access websites on a range of devices, including desktops, laptops, tablets, and smartphones. The software application used on these devices is called a web browser to access websites. Right? Google Chrome, right? Firefox, Internet Explorer, all these are what? Browsers. Right? Domain name and extensions. Domain name extensions are the last part of a domain name. For example, in google.com, the domain name extension is .com, and in GEHU, dot ac dot in, the domain extension is dot ac dot in. This is domain extension, right? And domain name is, a domain name is an identification string that defines a realm of administrative autonomy or a company, authority, whatever. And extension is that com.org and all. So this is basic for today, right? Domain name, domain extension, internet, website, intranet, extranet and all. Thank you. Thank you for the day.